Now that Holden's file is set up, let's take a look at Holden's first transaction. Can you imagine on January 1, Holden did 10 video hours for Alan? The expression on account means that Holden did not get paid at the moment he delivered the service. We know from a previous video that if a company delivers a service and does not get paid immediately, the proper source document is an invoice. We will record this invoice into QuickBooks. At the moment we do that, the chart of accounts and the numbers in the chart of accounts will change, because every transaction that you have will affect your general ledger. When the invoice is automatically recorded in the general ledger, the results in the trial balance will change immediately. So the general ledger and the trial balance is one set of records. However, this very same invoice is also going to affect another separate set of records that is inside your QuickBooks file. This same invoice is going to affect your customer records. The money amount for Holden's first transaction is $3,000. We remember that each video hour was $300, and there are 10 of them on this invoice. Right now, the trial balance has zero because we have not recorded any transactions. However, if we record a transaction that tells QuickBooks we have earned $3,000 in video income, then video income will show up for the first time as $3,000. Because we put it on an invoice, QuickBooks knows a customer owes us this money, and therefore accounts receivable will also show up on the trial balance for the first time as $3,000. In the other set of records, we use a report called the customer balance detail. That will show us exactly what each customer owes us at any moment in time. Right now, no customers owe us money. However, if we record the January 1 invoice, this report will show that this specific customer, Alan Arby, now owes us $3,000 for the first invoice, which is done on January 1. Before we record the invoice, let's open up both of those reports and put them next to each other. This way, we can see the results of the invoice show up on both reports immediately. We learned in a previous video that to open the trial balance, we click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. We also learned we have to slightly modify the report to make it a little bit thinner and taller. And we always, always change the date range of every report to all. We want to see the results of all transactions, regardless of date. Now, your screen will be bigger than mine because I can only capture a piece of my screen as I record this video. But you should put your two reports next to each other rather than overlapping. To open the customer balance detail, click Reports, Customers and Receivables, Customer Balance Detail. Notice it already has all chosen as the date range. Let's make it a little bit taller and thinner. And in my video, I will have to click back and forth between the two because I cannot separate them. I don't have enough space. But on your screen, you can put them next to each other like this, so that when you record your invoice, you can see them both changing correctly at the same time. To open the invoice window, from the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. This window is designed to look like an invoice, and the first thing you notice, it has tabs and a ribbon, just like the Microsoft Office programs. When you click the different tabs, the commands and the ribbons change. I do promise that we will explore most of the commands on the ribbon in later videos. However, it's best right now to collapse the ribbon so it will not distract us. Click the arrow in the top right and we can close out the ribbon. You should also notice that there's a pane or a panel on the right of this invoice. This is also another helpful tool for managing your customer information. But because this is our very first invoice, we will also close out this panel on the right. Click this arrow and it will collapse. You can make your invoice window a little bit thinner, and now I can show you on my screen the entire invoice window. Take a moment to set up your invoice window and make it look the same as mine. Put in each piece of information step by step. Click the customer arrow and we see the customers that we put on the list. Choose Alan and Alan's address comes on the invoice. Now I am recording this video on April 18th. However, we need to click the date box and go back to January 1 so we record the correct date for the invoice. Notice QuickBooks automatically put number 1 as the first invoice number, and QuickBooks will enumerate the invoices automatically. Click once under the word quantity and type in the quantity of 10. After typing in a field, we always push the tab key, which is located on the top left of your keyboard. Pushing the tab key, let me show you again, when you push the tab key, it saves the field and moves the cursor to the next field. Click the item code arrow and choose video. Notice, as soon as you choose video, the description from the items list that we put in previously comes up automatically, and QuickBooks remembers the price that we put for the item of video when we set it up on the items list. QuickBooks also automatically multiply the quantity times the price each, and now you have the amount of $3,000. Make sure your invoice looks just like mine before you click the Save button. At the moment you click the Save button, you might get some messages that are irrelevant, like this 90-day message. If you have this 90-day message, just click Yes. And we will explain that message in a future video. However, at the moment we record the transaction, notice the results are exactly as what we expected. Accounts receivable and video income showed up on the trial balance for the first time as $3,000. And just only Alan Arby is showing up on the customer balance detail as the only customer that owes us for an invoice. Now let's take a look at Holden's second transaction. On January 2, Holden did 10 editing hours for a different customer, Betty. He also did this job on account, and therefore he has to make another invoice. The total of this invoice should be $1,400 because we remember each editing hour is 140 and there are 10 of them on this invoice. Before we record this invoice, this is what the numbers are in the trial balance. If we record an editing job where we earned editing income of $1,400, then editing income will show up for the first time on the trial balance as $1,400. However, because invoice number 2 means that there is another customer that owes us an additional $1,400, then accounts receivable will increase by that amount and become $4,400. And that will be the result in the general ledger, and it will show on the trial balance. In the customer records, before we record invoice number 2, we have only Alan owing us $3,000. However, as soon as we record an invoice for Betty for $1,400, Betty's name and money amount will show up on the customer balance detail for what she owes us. That means the customer balance detail will show a total of $4,400 owed to us from customers, which, as you know, is the same as the accounts receivable balance in the trial balance. Let's take a look how to record the transaction. Once again, from the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. Notice QuickBooks knows this is invoice number 2. but you should know you could change this to anything you want by overtyping it. Let's leave it. The date is January 2. The customer from the customer list is Betty Boop, and her address comes up here. Click once in the quantity box and type in the quantity. Go to the top left of your keyboard and push the tab key. When you click the item pull down arrow, you get the two items that we put on the items list with their name and description. This one is editing. When we choose editing, QuickBooks remembers that that's $140 each, and it automatically multiplies 10 times the 140 to get us the $1,400 that we expected. At the moment we click save and close, again, we're just getting this message as a formality. Don't worry about the past transaction message, just always click yes. Now, the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Editing income has become $1,400. Accounts receivable has become $4,400. When we look at the customer detail, we see just Alan owes us $3,000. Just only Betty owes us $1,400. The total money that all customers owe us is $4,400, which is the same as accounts receivable in the trial balance, $4,400.